Good afternoon, Keller Williams, and welcome back to the KW Command 66 Day Challenge 3.0 Day 12. So today we're going to continue our series of lessons on contacts. We're going to come into our contacts submenu or applet here, second one down. And we're going to dive into one of our contact records. And yesterday we spent some time kind of talking about everything that's happening on this right-hand side of our contact screen or the right-hand panel. We have now covered timeline, how to add a contact to an opportunity, how to add a contact to a smart plan, how to assign a task to a contact and add a note. And today we're going to talk about saved searches. So if we have a buyer client looking for a property, let's just say 77493 is the zip code here in Katy, and they are searching for properties between 250 and 350. Four bedrooms or more, I have the ability within my KW Command contact record to set that client up on a saved search. So I can click on saved searches. It's going to show that this contact has not been added to any saved search. So let me go ahead and create a saved search. And you can see I can title this saved search. The client will be able to view this title. So just so you have a heads up, I could just basically say, four bedroom homes in 77493, and let's just say 250. I only have so many characters, right? So I'll just put four bedroom homes in 77493. Here is the primary email for AAA seller, which is the contact I'm setting this up for. You can see if I want to edit this, I have to go back to the contacts page itself, and I can get there by clicking on this link. With regards to the location, right now we can search for homes by neighborhood or by zip code. So I said we were doing zip code. So 77493 is the zip code. We're gonna choose that zip code, and there it is, it shows up. Price point, we said we were looking for homes between 250 and 350,000. And keyword, you could put in a keyword here if there was something specifically that the client was looking for. Just be careful because obviously you are then dependent upon the agent writing the description for that listing to include that keyword in their listing. I can also say that sometimes I have written pool in the description of my property, such as backyard big enough for a pool or a pool ready backyard or neighborhood pool, etc. in the description. And then I've had agents call me and say, hey, I set my clients up for a home with a pool and your listing keeps showing up. And I have to explain to them, you probably have a keyword search for pool, and my public remarks say pool in it, but it's not that the house has a pool. I'm not trying to be misleading. I'm just trying to tell you how big the backyard is or how close the neighborhood pool is. So just be careful with keywords is the bottom line there. Property types, I can click on the drop-down box here underneath property type, and you can see that there are several different options here. Let's say this client is strictly looking for a home. So I can say we don't need condos, don't need townhomes, don't need lots or land or multifamily, don't need apartments. I'd have to decide whether they want to look at foreclosures or short sales. Typically, those are a lot more work can get clients very excited about a price, and then they realize the process and they opt out. So I'll go ahead and leave in new construction. Obviously, if they want a house with a pool, then it's probably not going to be new construction typically, but I'll leave that in for now. And listing status, I can click on this drop-down box and see that there is for sale active, for sale pending, and for sale coming soon. I don't typically like to show my clients homes that are already pending. Obviously, that's a house that they could fall in love with and, you know, most likely not end up being able to purchase. So I'm going to uncheck that box, and then I can click in the box and the drop-down goes away. Bedrooms, we said 4+ bedrooms. Bathrooms, we're going to leave that alone, but you could choose bathrooms, full baths at least. Then you also have the minimum and maximum year built. So if someone says, hey, I want a historic home, maybe I say the maximum year built would be 1950. If somebody says I want a newer home, if you will, you could say minimum year built 2017. Okay, I'm going to leave those blank for right now. In addition, you have the living area. So how many square feet is the house? Minimum versus maximum here. And then you have three different choices. So does it have parking or not? Open house only. So this might be a search if you had clients that are looking for additional open houses. This might also go really well with the open house smart plan. And then there's price reduced within the last 7 days. So another toggle that you could choose. Once I click on create, it's going to show here is now the search that I have set up for my client. In addition, the client is going to get an email. So here is the email that I had set up, and it's going to say, Marty Miller shared a saved search for bedroom home. When I click on that, you can see this is the email that gets sent to the client. So it says, hello, search for a new home can be overwhelming, and that's why I'm here. Excuse me. Just so you know, I tested this earlier, and it may just be that I have the first name as AAAA, and the system recognizes that's not a real name. But when I tested it on myself as a contact, it actually said, hello, Marty, just so you know. So the system should be putting in the first name as long as it's not something silly like AAAA. Searching for a home can be overwhelming. That's why I'm here to guide you. I know your time is valuable. I want to make sure you only receive listings that meet your needs. I created this saved search, which contains homes that check all your boxes. Expect updates to this search in your inbox regularly, or click the link below to view your curated list at any time. Don't hesitate to reach out. So you can see that it has my name. It shows kind of what I put in for the description and then what the characteristics are that we're looking. And as you start to scroll down, it's going to show all of those properties that are available in 77493, or at least a series of them. And then it'll say see more updates, or I can also start up here at the top and I can click on see search results. When I do that, it actually loads their landing page. Marty's helped create a saved search for you. See 147 results. So a lot of homes available for sale in 77493. So the client can then see all of those here. As soon as they want to favorite a property, they will be asked to sign in for an account. If they've already created an account, then they don't have to. And yet, if they have not, they will be asked to go ahead and sign in, create an account with their password. From there, they can actually start using the collections option, which when they click on the favorite, it'll actually allow them to then put that property in a specific collection, either their favorites, or they can create their own collection categories, such as, you know, vacation home or beautiful kitchen, or, you know, kind of like Pinterest boards. They're going to have their own, they can create their own subfolders of listings and put them in there. So this is a great way for you to set up your clients. They can also click on each one of these pages. And the nice thing is, once they actually click on a listing, if we go back to my command record, you can see on the timeline that it shows, well, it did last time. Let me double check that. It looks like it didn't quite update, but last time I had this working, it did show that I actually viewed a property. So you have that opportunity for them to kind of track that. And then of course they have the ability to save that listing, ask you a question, or schedule a tour as well. So that is the ability to create saved searches. Right now you can only create one per contact. I know that we are working on the ability to create more than one, and yet for now it is only one saved search per client. Always kind of keep track of your notifications here in Command and your notifications in Kelly. That's typically where those notifications will show up if they fill out the form for more information, schedule a tour, etc. So just make sure you're staying on top of your command settings here. You know, always kind of check the bell periodically to see. Usually a red light will show up when you have notifications. And then of course, always pull up Kelly periodically to make sure you have no missing notifications in Kelly. That's pretty much it, guys. That is today for AAA Seller and their saved search for homes in 77493. Hope you're all having a fantastic day. Tomorrow, we are going to talk a little bit more about this big blue and white plus icon and some additional things that we can do in the contact records. And then we're going to be pretty close to wrapping up contacts and moving on to the next session that we have. All right, guys, hope you have a great day and look forward to talking to you tomorrow. Thanks so much.